Let's take a look at the Corona tail of the tape. Miguel Flores, Mario Briones. Flores, he's the younger fighter. He's faster. The one thing that the tail of the tape doesn't show, these two have been the pro for the same amount of time, for basically 6 years. The interesting thing is Briones has a lot more fights. So let's see if the experience, because he's been in the ring, better competition comes into play here. Let's get the official introduction from Ray Flores.
From the Cowboys Dance Hall here in San Antonio, Texas, Premier Boxing Champions now features the main event live on FS1, 10 rounds in the featherweight division. The three judges ringside are Glenn Crocker, Joel Elizondo, and Ellis Johnson. And the referee in charge, when the bell sounds, Rafaela Ramos. Introducing first, fighting out of the red corner, wearing the black and the silver with the Mexican flag. He is a 33-fight veteran who enters the ring with a record of 27 wins, 4 losses, 2 draws, 20 wins coming by way of knockouts. Fighting out of Villa de Puertecitos, Mexico. Ladies and gentlemen, here is Mario Maca Briones. Across the ring, his opponent fighting out of the blue corner, wearing the black with the gold trim. As a professional, undefeated, 18 wins, 9 of those coming by way of knockouts. Fighting out of Houston, Texas, by way of Michoacán, Mexico. Ladies and gentlemen, damas y caballeros, presentando the undefeated, el invicto, Miguel, el Michoacano, Flores.
Let's go. You received the pre-fight instructions, recibiste las instrucciones. Protect yourself, protégete todo el tiempo. Give me a clean fight, una pelea limpia. Buena suerte.
Well, Miguel Flores told us that this fight is all about showing the boxing community he's supposed to be here. He says, I want my performance tonight to serve notice to the featherweight division. Mario Briones, well, he's making his U.S. debut tonight. He told us he is going to put Miguel Flores through a war. Here we go, round one, and Flores comes right after him. Briones, he's got the black trunks, the silver trim. Flores, the black trunks, the gold trim. It's Flores with some jabs to the stomach.
Flores is working the left hand beautiful. He's doing that jab, followed by hooks or body shots. You know, that's the main thing. First, at the beginning of the fight, you gotta use that jab. Set up your opponent, learn from him, and see what your opponent's trying to do. He's doing a great job. Beautiful left to the body.
Keep in mind, the last time we saw Flores, it was November here on FS1. And remember, he stopped Alfred Tete with a left hook to the body. If you're looking for Flores, he's 18-0, got 9 knockouts. All of his knockouts have come with a left hook to the body. In fact, all of his amateur knockouts came with body shots. He said, I've never knocked anyone out going to the head.
Which is very difficult to do in the amateurs because the gloves are a lot more padded and comfy like that. So for him to be knocking out fighters to the body all the way back to the amateur says a lot about this kid. I really like everything I see so far. In the fighter meetings, he impressed me. He has a great team behind him. Solid prospect here.
Yeah, this kid is the real deal. You know, using that left, beautiful. And I know he'll get to the body sooner than later because he's got a beautiful left hook to the body that has won all his fights by knockout going to the body. So yeah, he's gonna start using the body shot. But so far he's using that jab and he's using it very effectively.
He's doing the smart thing, I think, because Briones has been around the world fighting and he's faced every opposition as well. So he can't just go in there thinking he's gonna fight just like anybody. He needs to take his time and dig those body shots.
There's that left hook to the body by Flores.
And that caught Briones' attention.
And a straight right.
was a perfect right hand that Briones was not expecting, because so far Flores is using nothing but left, nothing but left. And what out of a sudden came that right hand that Briones was not expecting.
Look at that jab. Another jab. Another. Now here comes Briones now.
Right there, that's what Briones needs to do in order to be able to be successful in this fight. He needs to pressure, stay on top of Flores. It won't be easy, but that's what he needs to do. He needs to take chances.
Beautiful body shot by Flores right now.
And an action-packed round one. There's that right hand. Round two, when we come back. Good look at Miguel Flores. He is unbeaten in his trainer, Aaron Navarro. They've been together for 15 years. You want to talk about a young man who took his turn, basically tragedy, into triumph. Flores, his older brother, Benjamin Flores, was a fighter as well. 7 years ago, injured seriously in the ring. Flores was ringside watching it. His brother ended up dying 5 days later. Instead of turning away from the sport, he said that motivated me more. Become a professional fighter. See, me and my brother both had dreams of becoming a world champion. Now that dream has increased for me because I fight not only for myself to be a world champion, but for him.
That tells you a lot of this young kid. Seeing his brother die after a fight, any other young fighter would have quit boxing. Now he's coming strong to do it for his brother. I think right there he's fighting in close, too close, where he's taking some punishment too. He's landing beautiful punches. And it looked like he could be on his way to a good win.
There's a left hook. That one hurt Briones. We are commercial free for the rest of this fight. It's the main event.
I'm just waiting for that body shot. I'm waiting for that body shot. But look, he's fighting beautifully. He's landing beautiful punches, but he's also taking chances because Briones is not as Briones is landing. Where the first round, all he had to do was just throw that jab on the outside and win that fight easy if he wants to win like that. But he wants to impress. He wants to please the crowd, and he came to give everybody a good fight.
And you can see this is the type of fight that Briones wants.
Yes, exactly. This favors Briones.
This was a fight I was expecting, actually, because I knew Briones was going to be a tough cookie. But if he continues doing this, he's going to keep getting hit. Briones landed that left hook I talked about, where it's a wide left hook. He also got hit with some big punches inside, too. Flores is not used to fighting in the inside against such a strong fighter, so he needs to be careful, but he's looking good so far.
Yes, and Briones knows he's going to take some hits in order for him to land.
Flores, right to the body by Flores.
Flores is the one taking chances. Right now, that's Briones' fight. Even though he's not winning and he's getting hit a lot, but this is the only chance. It's the only chance he's got on the inside and throwing punches.
And keep in mind, Flores told us in our final meeting, the key to me is using my feet. I got to box here. People don't know I can box. I can. But he says the problem is when I get hit, I want to fight.
He's not doing that. And I'm like Robert said, he's winning these rounds. Well, he's winning this round, but he's getting hit a lot. It's giving Briones confidence. Briones' only chance to win is to make it this type of fight. And Floyd is giving him that opportunity.
And let's not forget that this is better the second round. We got a 10-round fight. And experience, Briones has.
Flores has never gone past 8. Here's a stiff jab by Flores. Final seconds here. Body work by Flores.
Great body shot.
Well, this Saturday from New York City, two heavyweight titles are on the line. Charles Martin squares off against Vyacheslav Glazkov for the vacant IBF world title. And Deontay Wilder takes on Artur Spilka for the WBC heavyweight belt. It comes your way this Saturday, January 16th, from the Barclays Center in Brooklyn, New York. You don't want to miss it on Showtime Championship Boxing.
Here we go, looking at the white hook that I talked about. That's one of his favorite punches. It's a surprising punch because it looks like it's going to be a jab, but he turns it around in the last minute. And here goes Flores landing some great uppercuts, switching it up from the body up to the head. I like what I see from both fighters.
If you're Flores and you're looking for a knockout, keep in mind all of his knockouts have come within five rounds. This is round three.
Yeah, and if I was Flores and I was in Flores' corner, I wouldn't be looking for the knockout. I'd be looking to win those rounds by using that jab the way he did the first round. You know, he's taking too many chances by exchanging punches with Briones. Briones is a veteran, he's got experience, and he's got a lot of tricks in his pocket.
That's what happens when you're the main event fighter for the first time. You want to do something you're not used to or accustomed to doing, and you want to impress the crowd, all the family that's with you. Sometimes it works for you, and sometimes it works against you. Right now, it seems like it's working for him, but Briones is gaining confidence, that's for sure.
Take a look at our punch stats here through two rounds. It's Flores, who has landed nearly 40% of his punches. There's that left hook. And he came up top. There's a left hook by Briones. Rafael Ramos gives a warning. We're halfway through round three. That's another one. That went low. Double left hook by Flores this time.
Body punches to the body. You can hear him at ringside. He's picture perfect, and he does it with great technique. There's something about punching to the body that's dangerous, but if you do it with great technique,
Flores. That eye starting to swell on Briones.
I think he got a cut after that right hand. I think he's cut already.
There's that right. Flores is starting to go to work offensively now. Crowd chanting his name.
He's going to work offensively, but he's not doing it in a matter where he stays there to get hit back. He's actually moving and using his feet like he should have been doing this entire time. So now he's looking like the younger, fresher fighter beating the older veteran.
Yeah, he's beating him up with those right hands, and this might be his first fight that he wins by straight right to the head.
Briones just turned 30 yesterday. We come to the final seconds here of round three. And a cut over that left eye, Briones.
Here we see Briones try to land that right hand downstairs, but beautiful combination, beautiful counter there, a right hand counter. Left hook, right uppercut, and a straight right hand. This is something really difficult to do for a prospect. He threw a left hook, a right uppercut, and a same right hand. Very impressed here by the young Flores.
This kid is showing tremendous skills. You need to work on this side. You had him on the ropes, and you let him go. That's what they're telling him. He needs to keep him in the ropes. That's what he needs to do. That's the only type of fight that he's got a chance to win.
This is round four. We are scheduled for 10. Miguel Flores in the black trunks, the gold trim. He's unbeaten. Taking on Mario Briones. Briones making his U.S. debut. He he's got a cut over his left eye.
And it's a very big, dangerous cut. They were working out in the corner, but it seemed very big.
In case you're wondering, we're under the unified rules here in Texas concerning the cuts. In case of a cut, accidental headbutt, if it's stopped before four rounds, it's a no decision. After four rounds, we go to the cards. See how you, the fans, have this one scored. Here's a right hand by Flores thus far. And you've got Flores winning all three, the first three rounds.
I agree with the fans. You know, Flores is landing that straight right hand over and over. Even though he's getting hit a few times here and there, he's landing the better punches. And those right hands are really hurting Briones. Nice left to the body. Mm-hmm.
I think we're going to keep saying that throughout the fight as long as it lasts. Nice hook, light left hook to the body. That's his money punch. And watching this kid on video, Flores, he's just a picture-perfect puncher downstairs, and he knows it. All of his knockouts to the body. And right here, he's showing a different arsenal with straight right hands and patience and movement. Right there, he showed a little pivot to the right, a feint right now, combinations. Impressive.
Yeah, look, when we hear that he's won all his knockouts by body shots and since the amateurs, I thought he was just going to be a kid looking for body shots. He's a complete package. He's throwing a beautiful right hand. He pivots to his left. He pivots to his right. He throws beautiful combinations. I think he's a complete fighter. He's a real deal.
You're talking about there, Robert. Under a minute here in round four. There's another right hand.
Beautiful right hand. He dipped under to avoid the left hook that didn't come, and then he attacked again. Beautiful shots.
Three-punch combination by Flores.
Look, and none of the punches are to the body. And when he does go to the body, he plants his feet good and lands the beautiful punches. So he's doing an excellent job.
Under 30 seconds.
Flores showing some discipline here because he just landed maybe 10 to 12 unanswered punches. Any other young prospect would have went crazy right there, but he stood back and he got patient, landed the shots. He understands he's fighting a tough, grizzly veteran here.
Yeah, Briones would have won two. Well, coming up next week, it will be Fox Fight Week in L.A. First on Tuesday, January 19th, from Club Nokia, Jamal James takes on Javier Molina in the main event here on FS1. Saturday, January 23rd, from the Staples Center, we've got three fights for you. The main event, Danny Garcia taking on Robert Guerrero on Fox. First primetime fight on Fox since 95, Iron Mike Tyson. He took out Buster Mathis Jr. Don't miss it.
Rest, take your time. Use your feint. Use your jab. For whatever you start out with, coach, say your jab is working, you got to use your feint.
Jab and feint all the way through, son. Keep sliding out to your right, no matter what.
Look, the corner's giving him the perfect instructions. Keep using that jab, feints, jab, feints. Everything's coming off that jab and those feints. And that right hand that he throws after the jab is landing perfectly. So, yeah, the corner's telling him exactly what he needs to do.
This is round five. Briones comes out swinging. Briones making his U.S. debut, said it's such a big fight for me. He's from Aguas Caliente, Mexico. Hot water.
He said the mayor was watching.
The mayor watching the whole town. He said the million people. He said they're so excited that he's fighting here in the States. Briones says that one went low. Rafael Ramos is going to give Briones some time.
It looked like he was on the belt line, maybe a little bit low, but if he can get a chance to rest, that's something that that's something a veteran usually does. You know, he's going to set it with low and get some a couple of seconds to rest.
You're right. Cause we need to see the rematch because I don't think it was that low. But yeah, that was a veteran move.
Here's a right hand by Flores. Good counter right.
Great uppercut by Flores. I'm going to step back and landed a picture perfect right uppercut caught.
Ooh, nice left shot. One to the body by Flores.
Wait, no punch. No punch. That's it. Right up, you on it.
Stay diligent with the jab as well. There's a left hook by Briones. We have almost come to the halfway point of this fight, and Briones' face is battered.
Look at that beautiful pivot right there to embarrass Briones against the ropes. Just when Briones thought he had this young kid on the ropes, he pivots out nicely, jabs. Looks like a symphony in there. Looks nice.
Right hand, left hook, Flores.
Briones thought his experience was going to take over. It's definitely not doing it. You know, Flores is fighting beautifully. He, you know, like you're saying, he's moving around. Look at the way he moves out of the ropes.
Not only that, but he barely moves away from the ropes, and he doesn't come away from there. He attacks right after. That's a veteran move. Usually you pivot out and you go to the other side of the ring. He's not doing that.
Blood now just dripping out of that cut. Really badly for Briones.
Flores is cut now, I believe. Either that or he may have caught some blood from Briones.
Sneaky right hand there by Flores. And big right.
Flores is definitely cut, and he got rocked right there as well. This is the fight that I expected from the first round.
Great. Double left hook, Flores. Oh, my. Look at this action here. At the bell.
Great round.
We're going to see the punch that was a little bit low, and look, definitely was not low.
I didn't think it was low.
It was not low at all. It was actually a good punch because it actually hit the top of his shorts, and the punch was going up, so it was definitely not low.
Quick 1-2, slide to the right.
But Briones did the right thing by.
All right. That's it. Real nice and easy, baby. Big deep breath.
Hey.
Okay. I saw it.
All right.
Quick 1-2, slide to the right, baby. All right? Everything's good. Keep taking them apart. Don't fight with them. Keep boxing them, baby.
You heard the trainer telling you, look, don't watch your work. Quick 1-2, stop watching your work.
He's got a smart man in the corner, and they've done a great job. They've been together for many years. They know each other very well. The kid, Flores, feels very comfortable with this trainer, and they have a great future here.
Both of them got cuts over their left eye. Right hand, left hook, Flores. Take a look at how you and the fans have this one scored thus far again. Pitching a shutout we have Flores thus far.
I have Flores winning every round as well, and impressively as well, but he's getting hit. He's definitely getting hit. He's bleeding. Both men are cut. This is a perfect fight for Flores to really understand that the main event comes with a burden.
But the way he's getting hit, he comes back with beautiful punches. He's getting hit like any other world champion gets hit. You know, everybody gets hit. He's coming back with his posture, with his good punches. He's not losing control, even though at a young age, you know, only 18 professional fights, he's fighting like a real veteran.
He's facing adversity. I don't know if this is his first cut, but that is a pretty bad cut, and it's bleeding. When you're getting cut, it actually blurs your vision. The sweat gets in there, then the Vaseline might close your eyelashes. It just makes it more difficult, and if you're not used to it, it can actually be a bad thing for you going down into the the later rounds.
Uppercut by Flores. Briones comes back. So there's been no quitting Briones. Look as he continues to fire away.
Briones keeps coming, but that's showing a lot from Flores also. You know, his first main event, his fighting against a veteran. He's taking the fight like if he's also a veteran. He's getting hit a lot more than he's probably ever got hit in his fights, but he's taking it very well. He's probably cut for the first time in his career, and he's it doesn't seem like it's bothering him at all.
Under a minute.
Don't hold it. We keep saying veteran, but Briones has been fighting exactly the same amount of time that Flores has, but it goes to show you that Briones is the weather guy in there. He's the veteran. He looks like the veteran. His face looks like the veteran. He fights like a veteran. He's been fighting around the world just like an older journeyman. But he's not a journeyman. He's a hungry fighter. This is the biggest fight of his career. He said the most important, not the biggest fight, the most important. And it's showing here. Great left hook counter there by Flores.
You can see the blood just coming out of the cuts of both of these men. We come to the final seconds. Look at the body shots here by Flores. Left hook, Flores. Right uppercut. Right up the back.
Cinco. Okay. Estamos que de aquí arriba.
From now on, I need you to keep. We're way out on the bottom, you know. Go to the top. I need you to make him miss that jab. When he holds on to you, let go and throw punches. Don't move around. Throw punches.
That's a bad cut.
If you're going inside, so throw punches. Don't go in, just stay there. Go in to throw punches. Perfect. Perfect instructions, but he's not doing them. You gotta look for the body. You're not throwing body punches the way we trying to do it. I need you to pick it up. I need points. I need you to pick it up. Points.
Robert giving us the translation there in the corner. Mario Briones, you know, we go back to what we talked about at the beginning of this fight. We talked about the keys to victory. Let's start with Miguel Flores. Have you seen what you talked about at the top?
I've seen a little bit of everything and more, which is impressing me. I thought he was going to come out boxing and try to throw some throwaway punches, some decoy punches, and then finally get inside and land those body shots and avoid the left hook. But he's been getting hit a lot with those left hooks, and he also got cut. He's been getting hit with unnecessary punches, but this is a main event, and he's putting on a main event.
Well, as we take a look at our punch stats here through six rounds, 41% is what Flores has landed thus far. That percentage, almost 200 punches. We go back to what you talked about, keys to victory for Briones. You talked about starting fast, using that veteran experience. What have you seen?
Look, Briones did try to come the way I expect him to, but with a young Flores in front of him, with that jab and the straight right hands and the body punches, it's impossible. You just can't do it. You just can't do it against a talented kid like Flores.
Oh, that one went wrong.
Okay, time in, let's go.
Here Flores says, I'm okay, let's fight. Oh, there's Briones now. Trying to take the fight to Flores.
See, this late rounds is where Briones might be a little more successful because of his experience, and Flores never been past the eighth round, might take a little disadvantage in him, but you know, so far it looks like Flores is in control of the fight. But this last few rounds might make a a difference.
This is the second time for Flores that he's been in a scheduled 10-rounder, but as Robert pointed out, he has never been past 8. There's a 1-2 by Flores. And Briones comes right back, left hook Flores, though. Another hook by Flores.
Big punch by Flores. But Briones took it so well. I'm really impressed by both these guys right now. Briones for taking everything that this young, strong fighter's been giving him and the adversity that Flores has been going through with the cut and the shots and then coming. I'm just really impressed by both these guys right now.
Yeah, I'm impressed with Briones. You know, he's tough. He could take a punch. He keeps coming. His will to continue, his will to win, even though he's younger. But I'm really impressed with Flores. His skills, the way he's taking. He's also getting hit. But that also tells you a lot. The way he gets hit and comes back is also impressive. He's fighting like a true champion, like a veteran in the sport.
How about Briones? There's a left hook by Flores. But Briones standing right in the pocket.
And here we're going to look at the low blow, which it definitely was. It landed a lot lower than the other one. And you could see the pain in Flores' face. And here's the combination right after that. Left hook, right uppercut, counter by Briones. Really good action-packed round there by two bloody men.
You know, this has been a fantastic fight for these guys thus far.
That's where Flores gets hit in the low, you know, with a low blow. He comes back right away. He didn't want to give his opponent any time to rest, because his opponent is the one that needs time to rest. He didn't need it, so he came back right away. That's smart in his side also.
Absolutely.
Second call, let's go.
This is round 8. Flores tried to catch Briones coming in with that right uppercut. These guys just slugging it out at the bottom. How about this? In the pocket, going toe to toe.
Sweat flying everywhere, blood dripping, thudding punches. This is a really good fight.
This is a fight boxing fans love to see. Although all the fans here watching it live and those watching it on TV are loving this fight, might not be the best fight for neither of them. Flores, the young fighter, shouldn't be getting to this type of wars at this young in his career. But he's showing that he's capable of doing it if he has to.
Another warning. Referee Rafael Ramos. Flores has still been diligent though. He's using his feints. We're coming up on the halfway point here, round 8. Short right hand by Briones.
You can see how tough this Briones guy is. Good hook by him right there.
Left hook.
His best punch, the punch I keep talking about, he keeps landing it. He just can't hurt Flores.
Can hurt Flores, but he's got the power to hurt him. So this must be that Flores takes a really good punch.
Good punch.
So now how do we match Flores on with those top featherweights in the world? Might be a little bit too soon, yeah. but I think he's on his way to being able to challenge any of the top featherweights.
Well, you talk about Flores said, in his opinion, he thinks maybe 2 more fights like this, he wants to fight guys in the top 15. These guys again stand toe to toe in the center of the ring and just pounding each other.
A lot of those top 15 ranked fighters in the featherweight division. Maybe not the top 5, but he's ready for any of the top 15 guys.
and he just took another left hook right now. You're right, Robert. I think Flores does have a good beard because he's getting hit with some good left hooks here. He's taking them well.
He's getting hit with everything, and Briones has tremendous power. So that tells you that Flores takes it.
It was a low blow towards the end.
Yeah, these guys are fighting right up to the bell.
Here we see close action here, phone booth action, two left hooks. He returns the favor with left hooks. Both of them got good beards. They both take good shots. It just looks so much nicer in slow motion here. Briones is just, he's giving just like he's taking here. Great shots.
Pick 1-2 off is just a slide up to your right, baby. If you just stick with what's working, it'll work all night long. It hasn't stopped yet. Double on the jab, tighten up after you shoot, but make sure you move your feet a little after you shoot.
Second throw, let's go! Second throw,
so they're asking for the right hand, straight right hand. He's been landing the right hand over and over. Now it's not about who's better. It's just about who's gonna be in better shape and who hits the hardest. They both take a good punch. They both seem in good shape. I think it's just this fight might go the distance, and totally Flores has been winning most of the rounds. So I think this fight might go the distance, and it's all in favor of Flores.
And it's going to make him a better fighter because he's been knocking everyone out. Now he went 10 rounds, if he goes 10 rounds, against a veteran that's been in there with the toughest guys. So this is going to make Flores a better fighter in the long run.
Yes, it will. You know, he's not only been getting hit, he's cut. He's learning from this type of fights into those bigger fights in the future.
Great point there.
Minute now gone here in round 9. There's the right hand combination by Flores.
I don't know if you guys see the same thing, but Briones' cut is way bigger than Flores' cut, and they've done a better job in Briones' cut. He's not bleeding anymore. Flores, as soon as he stands from, as soon as the bell rings, he's already dripping blood. And Briones gets hit over and over, and it seems like they stopped the bleeding.
That's a good point. Briones connected with a left hook right there.
This is a good Briones round. I think he's landing the better shots here.
Yes, he has. These are the late rounds, 9 and 10 coming up. These are the rounds where Flores has never been in.
Briones' corner urging him to come forward. There's Briones now on the offensive.
Flores is coming forward, but he's coming forward with his head in the middle of the action. He can't just keep coming forward like that. He's taking a lot of good shots from Briones here.
You know, the interesting thing I was going to ask you, Robert, at the beginning of this round, at what point, if you're in Briones' corner, do you say, hey, you know what, it's enough. Maybe we should stop this thing, but...
Not anymore.
Yeah. Briones now.
I think right now what you got to tell Flores is, go back to your jab. You're not throwing the jab anymore, and that's why he's getting hit so much. This round is totally Briones.
Hold it.
30 seconds coming up here, left in round 9.
Flores is so successful when he's throwing the jab, pivoting to the side, pivoting to his right, throwing the straight right hand. He's not doing it anymore. He's turning this fight into a war, and he doesn't need to do this.
Goes to show you that Briones' corner knows their man well. They knew he was going to take some hard shots, maybe get cut, drop. But this fight is his in the later rounds, and now he's proving that because he's winning this round, and I think he won
this round was completely his.
Keep in mind, this is the farthest Flores has ever gone in his career. And it's a combination by Flores! Right at the bell!
Would that be enough to steal the round?
Maybe. Great left hook towards the end right there. He landed every shot he threw. Was it enough to win the round? Well, it is effective aggression, but both men were effective this round. I think this is going to be a close round for the judges. I wouldn't be surprised if they gave it to either one.
It was very close, but as you see Briones walking to his corner, he was stumbling walking to his corner. So that last hook to the head really hurt him.
And that's where the effective comes into the aggression. That's what the judges have to score.
Flores or his corner notices that, they got to jump on him right away. And it looks like Flores is, he's pumped up. He's ready for the lap round.
Here we go, 10th and final round. First time Flores has ever gone a full 10. That kid never gone past 8. Oh, there's a right hand by Flores. Double left hook. Stiff jab by Flores.
Beautiful double jab that Flores landed.
Flores headlining for the first time and trying to close the show.
If Flores fights smart, the way he's doing it with the jab and counterpunching, I think he could land one punch that is really going to hurt Briones.
Two heads collide and one. Look at Briones. Oh, he's woozy. Look at this.
After everything Briones has gone through and for the crowd to boo is just wrong, because this man has given everything, and that was a legitimate hard headbutt he took right there by Flores.
Take a look at the punch stats through 9.
Briones looks hurt, so it might be over soon.
You're in his corner, you got to keep on looking at that cut too.
Solid jab there.
Beautiful left hook.
He did. Minute gone. 2 minutes left in this fight. Left hook, Flores.
Look at that head movement that Flores is doing. Flores is finishing strong, finishing like a real champion.
Combination. Here comes Briones though. Still throwing.
Overhand right landed for Briones there. Even just when you think he's about to give up, he lands a big shot. And now he has Flores against the ropes. But Flores still has a lot of leg strength and showing you his youth there by going down. Great head movement. Returning some body shots there.
Body shots.
Here's a body shot by Briones. Flores returns fire. 1-2 to the head by Flores. Minute left in this fight.
Whoever was the matchmaker for this fight did a great job, because they gave the fans an amazing fight. It was a great main event, and it was a good transition for the young Flores to go from a prospect to a contender, and this is where he needs to be. It was a perfect test for him.
And for Briones, it might have been a career-ending fight, because he took a lot of time.
Flores got tied there, feet tied up. Here comes Briones now. Body broke there by Flores. We hit 20 seconds. What a performance by Miguel Flores.
I gotta say, it was the most one-sided, exciting fight I've seen in a while. Flores won and won easily, but it was a great fight.
And that's the fight. Flores unbeaten. Briones making his U.S. debut. The judge's decision when we come back. Well, the judge's official decision is in. Let's find out who won this fight. Here's Ray Flores.
Ladies and gentlemen, after 10 rounds, we go to the scorecards. Here are your score totals. Judge at ringside, Joao Elizondo, has the contest 98-92. And judges Glenn Crocker and Ellis Johnson see the bout the same, 100-90. All for your winner by unanimous decision, Miguel and Michoacano.
No surprise there. Miguel Flores remains unbeaten. Hey, I'd love to see Mario Briones again making his U.S. debut. Hey, he did well for himself. You see him? He said by the end of the year, he would love to fight for a title.